So hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to find a substring present in a string in C++. So I'm going to use here substr function. So first I will show you how this substr function works, and it's then really simple piece of code. Okay, so let's get started. So currently I have here an empty C++ program with a main function. First, let's just input the main string and substring from the user. So it's going to be string. MA be the main string and sub be the substring. So as I told you earlier, I want to show you a demo of substr. Okay, so suppose let us consider MA will be equal to some A, B, C, D and E. Okay, so this substr function is basically like used to break a particular string into parts. So we can just iterate through a particular string and get some middle element, first two elements like that. We can easily like get access to the elements present in the string. So for example, if I now just see out MA dot, so this is how it's work. String name, the variable string name, and dot substr. Okay, and here you can just specify the position. For example, now let me just show you a quick demo. Means if I just put 2, 2, 2, okay, so I am putting 2, 2 over here, and this A is going to be 0 and B is going to be 1, C is going to be 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, as you know here, so A is going to be 0, 1, 0, B is going to be 1, and this 2, what 2, 2 does is, first it goes to the second position. The first parameter that substr takes is going to be the starting position. Okay, so 2 is the starting position, so it iterates from 0, 1, 2, and here our second position is 2. Okay, it goes here, and next is the count of elements to be displayed from that position. So we are here at C and two elements from C. So C is also included. So the two elements from C is going to be C and D. So if I now just run this code, I will be getting C and D in the output. So as you can see, I got C and D over here. And if I just change it to 3, I will get CD. So that's it. And if I just put pass only one variable 2 over here, I will get all the elements from that particular number. So basically I get CD because I have put 2 over here. So from 2 till the last, if I put 0 means I will be getting the entire string. Okay, so ABCD. So that's really fine. So this is just a simple substr. Okay, so a simple function. I hope you are fine with this. So now let's just go into our main program. So just input both the strings. Okay, main and our sub one. Substring. Okay, so once we have done it, we need to find the length of our substring. Okay, so it's going to be let int l equal to sub dot length. Okay, length is the function used to find, say, inbuilt one. So we are good to that, and next thing is just simple comparison. So it's going to be we are going to use a for loop int I equal to 0 and I plus l less than or equal to MA dot length. Okay, I will explain this code. It's a little bit tricky over here. I will just explain it. Okay, so MA dot length, I hope you will be knowing this. It's the length of the main string, and L is the length of our substring, and I is the iterator variable that is used to iterate through our main string. Okay, so why we are using here I plus L is that, suppose for example, let's consider A, B, C, D, E, and we have given the main string is this one and our substring is D. So when I reaches C value, our like I value will be 2 and our count is of D is 2. So it's going to be I plus D. And when it reaches D, and suppose if that string is not present in there, so what if it's like DD, okay, DD. So DD is not present over here. So when it reaches this point, it will be I plus 2, but we have only one element over here and this element is not present over here. So to avoid that extra iteration over there, we can just use this command over here. So I plus L less than or equal to length of our main string. So if I run this code, I hope you will be really familiar with that. So next thing is the if command. So if statement, and if here we are going to check the condition. So if MA dot length, MA dot substr, okay. So our main string substr of, so here we will be passing two arguments. One is going to be I, comma, and our length of our substring. So I, comma, L equal to sub. So it's really simple code. Okay, as I told you earlier, I will be that 0, it will be iterating from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. And L is the length of the string. So it's just really going to be, it's going to be I, so for example, A, B, C, D, E. And our element to be found is D. It will just go 2 by 2. So first I value will be 0. It will start, it will scan A, B, return A, B. So A, B equal to sub, it's false. And next I value will be 1. So it scans B, C, B, C not equal to E. So I value will be 2. Scans C, D, C, D not equal to D. And I value will be 3. So 3 and D, D equal to E. So this is how this sub str I comma L equal to sub is going to work. So that's it. Just see out found, okay, and just break the statement for loop. So this is for finding what if the element is not present. You can just basically simply use a flag. So in flag equal to 1 over here, and you can just convert the flag value equal to 0. And so you can just place here a if condition. So if flag equal to 1, so if the substring is not present, it isn't going to go inside this if condition itself. So our flag value will remain 1 throughout the program. So that means that that substring is not present in the main string. So we can just simply print not found. See out not found. So that's the code over here. It's quite a simple thing. So our, so if the sub str, we aren't using the sub str, it's going to be really different, difficult. We need to use like two for loops, okay? Two for loops, like check the starting character and check the rest of the characters also. It's going to be a tedious process, but this sub str makes our work really simple. So if you just execute this code, so let me put that A, B, C, D, E over there, and I will put D. So I'm getting found. I will show you a couple of other demos also. So A, B, C, D, E, and I will put ADCD, okay, I will put AD, I'll be getting found. And if I put some other thing that isn't present in that, ABCDE, and if I put GHH, so it's going to be not found. So another thing, and this statement over here, if I don't give here this less than or equal to, what it's going to do is it's going to skip the last character, okay? So suppose I will show this one for you, ABCD. And if I just go and put the substring as D, I'll be getting as not found. So that's why we need to put here less than or equal to. It's really important to do less than or equal to. So that's it for this program. I hope you understand this code. And my name is a programming channel. Do check other videos of my channel. Blender tutorials in C, C++, Java, Blender, Unity, Python. So do check other videos of my channel and any subscribe and support me. And thanks for watching.